There's another kind of a breathing that I feel relates to the embryology. And in BMC, we look at cellular breathing. If you place your hand around one of your other arm, and in the same quiet way that Nina helped us to come back to that quietude, can you feel or open to that your arm is expanding and condensing with your breath? It's both your hand that's expanding and condensing with the breath, and also your forearm or your wrist, whatever you're touching, that it's expanding and condensing with breath. And I would ask you not to be concerned, is it matching your lung breathing or not, or your belly breathing, but to simply open the back of your brain to receive the subtle expanding condensing of the breath in your forearm on one side and your hand that's crossed over from the other side. So not making anything, again, Jonathan, this would be the awareness is the act, not a making, expanding, and condensing. And it may or may not be following the breath of your lungs. If you can just be open to your hand and your forearm, rather than directly your breath. Then releasing and just seeing what you notice. Again, it's the awareness coming in through the back of your brain. So it's your arm that's aware, not your brain. Your arm on one side, forearm, and your hand on the other side. And then changing your other hand on your other forearm. So opening not so much to your breathing directly, but to the expansion and condensing in your hand. It's a fluid movement, and in your forearm. In a certain way, in your brain, there's a falling backward rather than a falling forward. Falling backward of the back half rather than a falling back of the front half. The front half, if your eyes are open, can see everybody else in the room. You don't need it to perceive your arm. Your eyes are closed, it's more difficult to let go of the front because you don't have the external to draw you forward. So your hand and your wrist don't need your looking at them. they can be alive without your looking to see if they exist. You could look outward at the paintings, the room, the light, the plants, other people, not paying attention necessarily, but just allowing that light to awaken you to the outside. Your wrist and hand do not need your brain to know they exist. So it's not looking at the outside, just allowing it to exist. With your eyes open, it will help you in the awareness of your hand and wrist. Not to stare, but to allow the light of the outside to enter without judgment or analysis. Kind of neutral. And in that outer neutrality, another kind of knowing in your wrist and hand, separate from your identity. And then releasing. So this is one exploration of cellular breathing. Ultimately, where the whole body is simply breathing in the cells without identity, in a way, without having the I attached to it.
Could you say again why you would not have the eyes closed? It feels to me often in yoga anyway, we close the eyes when you touching someone so that you're not distracted by.
Yes. It's not wrong to close the eyes. It's not wrong to open the eyes, etc. They're just different practices. So, and this, I can share my experience. I can't teach you anything. I can just share my experience, and then you have your own, Catherine, of course. Let's say, it's not in the room right now. There's a quietude here. But let's say I'm distracted by, my sympathetic system has, I'm not going there, but probably some, it is going a little bit. I'm more aware of you than I am me, in a certain way. So I close my eyes so that I can be aware of me. And I let you recede away. Now I open my eyes, I'm still more in me. You are somewhere beyond me. In this exploration, I closed my eyes to feel my hand and wrist. But as my hand and wrist feel themselves, I can open to you and not be distracted. Because I know in my cells where I am. I don't know if that's helpful. It's a process.
It's very helpful. I feel that you're stabilizing in awareness.
So you're finding a stable place where you're not distracted. So you can do two things at once.
The stable place are in my cells, my blood, all my fluids. So this is here aware. So now I can take my awareness of you, where in the beginning the awareness of other was taking me out of myself. And then I went into myself away from you, and then how do I find a place where both can exist?
I'm curious if the cellular breath...
I don't know if they can hear you.
I'm curious if the cellular breath rhythm is synchronized, like the cells are all doing it at some time. I kind of can't imagine that, I wasn't clear if I was feeling my blood flow or the cellular breath, because the blood brings the oxygen to the cells. So is there a difference for you, or are they the same, the rhythms?
They're all different.
All different?
Yeah, because that's why I asked you also if you could not to try to synchronize what's happening in your wrist and hand with your breathing. Allow whatever's happening not to be directed, so that something can happen that you haven't done before, so you don't know how to direct it, because you don't have experience. Then there are practices where we do direct. I'm not saying not to do those. This is just one that's non-directive. We can do anything.
So just to clarify, the heartbeat's not the rhythm of the cellular breath.
Correct.
Okay, thank you.
The cellular breathing, it depends where you put your hand. And if you had your hand in two places, but you could have two hands, they may or may not be synchronized. We do in the developmental work something called navel radiation, where you have this leg and this leg and your tail and this arm and your head, and they're moving, and there may not be as much freedom in one side as there is in another, or there may be, or at some point maybe you do feel they're all synchronized, but you may not, relating through the navel.
I want to know if there is a connection between cellular breathing and the embryonic breathing that we were exploring last week.
Yes, we're moving into yet another breathing. They're all related, but they're not necessarily the same thing.